Hey everybody. Hi, I'm gonna take a shot of butterscotch and wash it down with some Heineken. Oh, what a great taste together. So I got some zines. I got Hypno Video number 17. This one reviews all anthology films. And a lot of people seem to want to get a hold of this, or a couple, like two or three people that have asked me about it. And it's by Cobb Labs out of Pensacola, Florida. And he's already on issue 17. I'll put the address in the description below. I got Dangerous Encounters number, I don't know, maybe like 3 or 4. This one is just jam-packed with text. And I don't know, say he reviews like 30 movies. I've heard of like 2 of them. And he just does all these interviews with just filmmakers I've never heard of. So it's really good for that. I mean, it's just, I like discovering, like, you know, I don't want to read about stuff I've already seen a bunch of times. I want to learn about new stuff. The Dangerous Encounters. I got Scum Culture number 1. Hey, thanks. And Angabot. Aaron and Angiebot, anyway, this one's pretty sleazy. It's really good. It does really good collages, and he really likes Linda Blair. He reviews The Nest, and he reviews Night of the Bloody Tapes, issue number 1. And a lot of cool art. This is a cool zine. It's from Germany though, so you have to contact. He's on Instagram, but I'll put his address. Got the new Lunch Meat was the first magazine that reviewed VHS. They started it all and remain at the forefront ever since. And I printed up some issues of Little Bouncing Bunnies number 2. This is a really great zine. It's really offensive, racist, sexist, homophobic, and it's great. A lot of death metal reviews and black metal interviews with Lord Blasphemer, Carrion Crawler, Incantation, and Metallica. Metallica interview is great. And I just made some. I'm going to give some to friends. Maybe you'll get one. Time for that. Man, I got a buzz from that. I was hungover today, so this is going to help. In my bitch slicer shot glass. I'm listening to Misery, Revel in Blasphemy. I got this Morbius Epic Collection. Yeah, he's just a great character. I've read just his like Spider-Man appearances. Just a great old Marvel horror character. He appeared in She-Hulk. And then lastly, I posted these on Instagram. And these are just great covers. I had to have them. Hopefully Marvel, they've done 2 epic collections of Conan the Barbarian. I have both of them. It has the first 26 issues. I hope that they just do the entire series in those epic collections. But I had to get these for the cover. Here's 107, Talons of the Man-Tiger. It's an awesome cover. Just bask in it. Soak it in. And this one, let me go in order. 107, 40 cents from like 1980. Snout in the Dark. Just awesome cover. Just makes me want to read it. Like, I really want to know what's inside this. Yeah, cool monster. Just love it. And then Conan the Barbarian 113, Satan Had a Son. It's another just great monster. Just, and then, like, I was like, is that kid trying to hurt Conan, or is he trying to help him? I think he's trying to hurt him. Because I skimmed through it, and he's like a little devil kid. He's got horns. You can't really see him. You can't see him there, but he's got horns. So, The Devil Had a Son. It's just an awesome title. Man. Lastly, I got Punisher 2099. And you know, like, everybody, you know, if you try to justify, like, liking comics by, like, oh, Watchmen, Dark Knight Strikes, like, the Dark Knight comic book, what else, Crisis on Infinite Earths, just whatever, you know, whatever they say is a really good and means something. This one, I read it in, like, I think 5 minutes. It's just a great revenge tale. This guy kills the Punisher's family. He kills his mother, his brother, and his sister-in-law. And, like, in the future, if you have enough money, you can just pay, you know, pay for whatever you did. So this guy, his name is Kron. You know, he just pays off the judges. Or, you know, you can, it's legal. And he tells, he tells the Punisher, he's all, I know how you must be feeling, Jake, but time is a great healer. I phoned you this evening. You should have gotten over it. God damn it. You have gotten over it by now. I thought that was just funny. And then, this Punisher's name is Jake Gallows. He has a, what do they call it? A power bat. And it's like this spiked staff. Like, at the edge, it's like spikes on it, and you can turn the density level from, like, rubber to titanium steel, and he uses that to kill with most. Like, he'll wound him and just beat him to death with that battle staff. So that's cool. That's different. So I'm gonna try to get the whole series of this. I have a couple of them. I'm just surprised. It's pretty good. The more I go back to comics, I just like characters like Punisher, RoboCop, Judge Dredd, just the vigilantes that just kill people. And Spider-Man, he's my favorite. So, man, that gave me a buzz. So we'll go out with, how about Snout in the Dark? And check out those zines.